Good afternoon to all. Have you ever thought about what would happen to rice production by 2030? I had, because my research directly related to this particular topic. Rice is the main staple food in the world, and the rice production should be increased nearly 50% to meet the ever-increasing population growth in 2050. But this is quite challenging due to two reasons: climate changes and numerous rice diseases. So my PhD depends upon a particular rice disease called as rice blast, which is due to fungus Magnophthegisia. This fungus disturbs the entire rice plant, hence cause US$66 billion production loss annually, approximately 60% in yield. At the moment, this is the main rice disease in the world, and it is controlled by using fungicides, which cause a lot of environmental pollution and lethal diseases such as chronic kidney disease. Because of this, scientists have directed their efforts towards identifying blast-resistant cultivars which have resistant genes in the genome against this disease. What are resistant genes? DNA fragments. How to identify them? By using DNA markers, again a DNA fragment which is located very closely with these resistant genes in the plant genome. So if you can identify resistant genes, you can easily transfer them from a resistant background to a susceptible background, hence convert it to a resistant one. This was the main object of my research, developing a durable blast-resistant cultivar in Sri Lanka. So what really blew me away was how to use this technique. I used a very different approach. First, phenotypically. Secondly, molecularly by using DNA markers. I identified highly blast-resistant Vietnamese cultivar, TETIP, which had three characterized blast-resistant genes. Then I bred it with the Sri Lankan highly blast-susceptible variety BG94-1. Why BG94-1? Because it's very popular here, it had very good traits. So after three backrow generation by following marketed backcrossing protocol, finally I've been able to develop a new highly blast resistant rice population, which we named it as BC3F4. This specific rice population had most of the characters of BG94-1 together with the blast resistant character which came from TETIP, and their resistance was confirmed molecularly by the presence of about three resistant genes. So indeed, this is very safe, cost-effective technique. Most importantly, it can save 60% of our rice production. Moreover, in simple words, I've converted a susceptible country to a resistant one that can withstand this devastating disease. Furthermore, in our research, through marker genotyping process, we identified two DNA markers, and these two DNA markers can be used in future rice breeding program to identify potent blast-resistant cultivars in Sri Lanka. Altogether, all these research findings will be immensely contributed to Sri Lankan and global rice breeding, not only for this rice disease, even for other rice diseases too. And at last, I'll reckon, it will no longer be a fairy tale using DNA marker technologies in our rice program. This research is very challenging and catalyzing. If you continue this wise initiative, I can guarantee you there's definitely light at the end of the tunnel. Thank you very much.